We are in early October. I have the fireplace going. Got myself a little hot cup of something, and I thought it would be a perfect opportunity to have a little fireside chat. So, what I have here in this cup is blueberry tea, by the way, because I figured somebody might ask me, because look at the color of that. One of my viewers, who also is in my Facebook group, WW Living Life on Track. If you're not in that group, please come on over and join us. We would love to have you. We do lots of extra stuff in there, so we'd love to have you if you're on Facebook. But anyway, she told me about it, and I thought it sounded so good that I had to go out and find it. I don't know if this is the one she was referring to or not, but this sounded really good, and it did not disappoint. It is really good. So go grab your favorite cup of something, coffee, tea, whatever you want, soda if you need it, and let's have a little chit chat. So what I wanted to talk to you today about are the things that I've learned along the way in my almost 40-pound weight loss journey that I think can really help those of us that are on WW Freestyle or any other diet program, lifestyle change program. I really think that all these tips that we're going to cover today are things that I wish that I could have just fast forward and learned and been able to implement them in my journey. It would have helped a lot. So let's just jump into those things. Okay, so number one, you need to ask yourself in a very serious way, not in sort of a, you're in the middle of doing a laundry and you ask yourself this question and then you throw the bleach in. No, you need to have a little sit down with yourself and ask yourself, are you ready to change? Now, what do I mean by that? You might say, really, Barrett, because that's kind of obvious. But if you're going to make a lifestyle change, and this is going to be something that is lifelong, and it will, WW Freestyle, keto, low carb, what South Beach, whatever diet program you are choosing, choose that as a lifelong journey. So I'll link below. I have a quiz that I put together to help you choose the right diet. Whatever diet, lifestyle diet you go on, you need to look at that as something that you're going to do from here forward. Because if you utilize, let's just use WW Freestyle, if you use that program for something that helps you take off, like myself, almost 40 pounds, then why would I do it for a couple years and then go off it? If I do that, you know what's going to happen? I'm going to put the weight back on really, really quickly. So you have to ask yourself, are you ready to make a permanent change? Now, am I saying that means you can never eat chocolate again? You can never have ice cream again? You can never have a plate of pasta again? Of course not. That is not manageable. No one can do that. But you have to know that in the interim, in the short term, and as you're really digging in and making these changes, you have to be willing to make the change. You know, I'm going to tell you guys honestly, there was probably a year when I said that I was dieting, but I would not get rid of pasta. I would not. I'm Italian and pasta is in, it runs through my veins. I wasn't getting rid of it. I wasn't getting rid of olive oil. I wasn't even, to me, a plate of pasta, I would say I have to have it. That doesn't work. You have to be willing to change your habits. Number two, are you willing to say no to yourself? This is something that you have to be willing to do. You have to be willing to say no to yourself. So, what do I mean by that? Let me give you a really good example. And some of you are going to get mad at me right now because don't mess with my coffee. I want my coffee the way that I want it. I refuse to change it. Not going to do it. I'm going to drink that creamer no matter what. Okay, is that you? Because I know that that's my husband and I know that that's my daughter. And let me tell you, For a little while early in my journey, that was me. I wanted sugar and cream in my coffee, and nobody was going to convince me that that, whatever the amount is, I'll say 2 tablespoons, but we all know it was a half a cup of vanilla creamer in my coffee. We know that what that was doing on a daily basis. And I wasn't having one cup, I was having 2 cups, and maybe I was having another cup at 3 o'clock in the afternoon. So I know now that I was probably drinking 9 or 10 points, maybe 12. And okay, so fine, I'll go ahead and start sugar-free. Well, guess what? That doesn't really do it either. It's a good stepping stone. And I had mentioned to you guys before that I have a whole, I've actually already done the video on how to get off creamer and get to black coffee, which is what I do now, by the way. But I got equally as many people who were willing to change and wanted to make the change, equally as many said exactly what I just said in the beginning. Not going to do it. You're not, don't take my coffee. Okay, number 3, get very, very familiar with what your why is. And I know that what is your why is kind of the, I don't know, it's the thing that a lot of people say nowadays, but I really want you to dig deeper than that. And not only dig deeper, sometimes digging deep means just getting to a simplistic level. And again, I always say to you guys that I use myself as the guinea pig. I put myself through the ringer so that I can bring you guys accurate information and how it felt for me or how this tasted to me, those type of things. So I'll just say to you, when I really came down to what is my why, it was not so I can be here for my kids, so I can be here for my grandkids, so that I'm healthy as I age. Yes, of course those things are a given, but you know what my why was? Because when I'm in the bathtub and I go to shave my legs, I feel like I have truly a Michelin tire around my stomach and I can barely bend my legs to shave my legs. Okay, number 4. And I'm going to tell you guys so many of these things, like I just said, I can relate. So I hope you know anything I say is not in a judging way. I live it. I am it. I do it just like you guys. I do the same thing. So one thing that I really needed to come to terms with is you're going to have to be willing to try different food. You're going to have to be willing to understand that a full fat chef salad is not going to taste like something with lower fat cheese and lower fat salad dressing. At first, you're going to get used to and probably start craving the lower fat products and, you know, things that are maybe sugar-free, because we tend to crave what we eat. That's just kind of a natural phenomena that happens. But in the beginning, when we're doing things that are lower in fat and lesser in sugar or sugar-free, they're not going to taste exactly the same. So, you know, just like, for example, my husband, I do all the cooking in the house. And the first time I did my little muffin meatloaf, which I love, I do them all the time. And I didn't do them with, obviously, with 80-20 hamburger. I did it with 93-7. And I didn't put as much of the breadcrumb that I put in there. There was things I changed. I didn't use. I put ketchup in mine. I used sugar-free ketchup. It tasted different. Did it taste good? Absolutely. But to him, he said, well, this isn't the same. I don't want to have this anymore. And I said, well, you know what? Then you don't want to lose weight too bad. Okay. And then number 5, the last and final thought that will help you along in your weight loss journey is remember, this really is a journey. If you make a mistake, and we're going to say mistake because we all want to stay on plan, okay? Yes, we're going to have days that we get derailed. That's what I want you to really understand, that if you have a day where you are just, it's one of those days, you're sugar craving beyond belief, and no matter what you've tried to do, it's not working, and you go eat a half a pizza, you have to be able to forgive yourself and move on, because you're going to be in this lifestyle diet for the rest of your life. So remember, put it into perspective of what it is throughout your entire life. Is that half a pizza really going to make a difference in your life? No. You just have to make sure that you get right back up, not the next day, but the next meal. And that's one thing that I always had trouble with, is that if I had a bad eating meal, which does happen, you guys, it happens to all of us. If I eat way too much, or I say the heck with it, this is good, and I'm going to dump a whole heck of a lot more cheese on this, and I know that in that one meal, I blew not only all my weekly points, but I also blew the next week. You know, I ate everything and then some. If you're on any other type of diet, let's say you're on keto, and you know what? You just decided to eat an entire basket of chips. What I'm saying is allow yourself that, okay, that was a step back, but the next meal will be a step forward. Don't take that as an opportunity to say, well, I've already blown the day, so the heck with it. Tonight I'm going to go ahead and get an ice cream sundae and I'm going to eat everything else I want because I already blew it. That's one thing that, you know, sometimes you just have to track and move on. And if it's, you know, something that it's impossible to track, then you know what? Call it what it is. You wiped out your day and you wiped out your weeklies. Okay, next meal, get right back on the horse. Allow yourself a little bit of grace in that regard. So those are the top five things that I hope will help you, and I think they apply to any diet. Tea is one of my favorites. I'm going to continue drinking this blueberry tea by the fire. And until next time, I'll see you guys.